तेरे कवन कवन गुण कह कह तू साहिब गुणी निधान तुमरी मेहमान तुमरी मेहमान बरनना तू ठाकुर ऊच भगवान तू ठाकुर भगवान.
The Mohammedan scriptures tell us each man must have some beloved. What sort of beloved? Not that one leaves you, but who is ever with you, who does not leave you in this life and in life hereafter. And who can be he? You have the God in him. Children of light. I was wondering how should I address you, because I see you in me and I in you. So I think the best way I can address you as my friend. I have not made you slaves, but as equals. Because an equal man can only recognize what he is. Those under him, they cannot know from that status. So you are all my friends, so I have love and regard for you. So love is the way back to God, all Master says. Read any scripture, and there we are wanting. We are very intellectuals, we are very wise in all other affairs, but we are wanting in love. Love is not grown in any fields. Cannot be bought but any, shops. It is already within you, ingrained within you. It is innate. Simply that love has been misfit. There are so many senses which are dragging us to the outgoing faculties all the world over. You like to control one passion, you must have control all outgoing faculties. If you control one organ of sense and let others let loose, the result will be, it is just like putting hands into the fire and seeing that it should not burn. So this is what is required. You see, control over senses. For the senses work the attention, which is the outcome of our souls, expression of our souls, which is diffused into the world through the senses, sense organs. Result is where we go, where we are attached. So this love which is misdirected, you see, is called love. But if you just look to its reality, you'll find it is God in itself. When it is just withdrawn from outside, because God is love and our soul is love, we come in there, we come in contact with all love. So this is what is required. So mind that love is a gift from God to man, Love seeks union with the beloved. First there is yearning, there is pining. You want to see him, to be near him. What is love? What is the result of that? When love is there, whatever for whom, you are always constantly in sweet remembrance of him. That is the outer token of love. So love ultimately, after journeying, wants to be near him, first to obey him, then obedience will result in surrender, like that. So obedience is the player of the beloved. How you want to be obedient? You want to seek the player of the beloved, whom you love. One who loves is the lover of the beloved. And one who obeys is the beloved of the beloved. If you love the Master, Master loves you most. You become the beloved of the beloved. We have not ever thought of the value of love. So you will find one who surrenders all has no existence other than the beloved. The surrender is in above obedience. Obedience sometimes you do willingly, you see. But surrender means giving up everything for the beloved. You have got nothing else except the beloved. So greater than love is obedience, mind that. Greater than love is obedience. And all these can be summed up in love divine. This is perhaps the only lesson or the injection or the counsel I can give to make you successful in all things of life, especially your spiritual life. Because whom you love, you abide in him. Christ said, let my words abide in you and you abide in me. How can you abide in him? First is obedience. Second is surrender. Whom you love as you think, so you become. Fifth Guru of the Sikhs tells us that the disciples remembers the Master. And what does the Master do? Whom does he remember? His 11 souls. Never think for instance that the God and the Master forget you. To love the Master, to love God. The God in him, not the Son of Man. So no amount of intellect can fathom God. No amount of austerity can enable you to attain God. Only whom, when one loves him and loses oneself in him, can find him. And it is only the feet of the love in which you can lose yourself, where the two become one. And there is no other means, no other way back to God except through love. Love man only revives the man. You see, when you are in a loving mood, your face flushes, isn't it? When you are wanting, now you sad, pensive, long face you have got. In the outer ways, you find this change, even that very low love. It just, you see, overflows your soul. So we go to your Master because he is overflowing in love. When you go near him, your love is flared up. The love which starts in flesh and ends in flesh, that is no love. That is passion. Love that starts from flesh and dissolves in the soul, that makes two into one. So love burns the lover, and devotion burns the beloved. He has to take care of everything of you when you are devoted. So love seeks happiness for the beloved, not for the self-mind man. We sometimes love in a business way. Love knows giving. So devotion seeks blessings for the beloved. Quiet look is all he wants, nothing more. He is not showy. Well, you see, he sees the heart in you. That power is residing in you, which is just working at that human pole. He sees all hearts, also there with you. So love is, devotion seeks blessing from the beloved, but love seeks to shoulder the burden of the beloved, and devotion throws the burden of the beloved. So love gives. Love does not require the presence of the beloved. Mind that, in order to love. One who loves, he loves. He is never alone. A lover is never alone, mind that. He may be in the wilderness, he is a sweet love for the Lord. He resides in him. The beloved resides in him. They are one with the, they are near or far. So devotion asks, and love is silent and sublime, devoid of outward expression. So such is the ideal of love, you see. What Master always referred to, love, 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 and love. Love is a great blessing. So devotion expresses itself in outward things, but devotion demands the presence of the beloved to express affection to the beloved. So what is greater than love and surrender? So this is the message that has been given all along by all masters whenever they came. I am giving you no new thing on this birthday, what you are going to celebrate. My true celebration of the birthday will lie in the fact if you live, have love, have a life of love. Love and all things shall be edited. To my mind, I don't feel joy at the day I was born, you see. I will feel joy only the purpose for which I meant that is complete. Then I feel joy. Yeah, I quite appreciate that you have expressed all your love, devotion or surrender, that you may decide between in your own heart. So I want you to love, you see. That will give you physical health, moral health, and spiritual health. That's the only way back to God. So physically, you see, sometimes it's not possible to be everywhere. But the God in man, God in him, is everywhere. That can materialize everywhere. When you rise above body consciousness, there also you can contact and talk face to face. So this way, you are all on probation. But such nothing, not such a probation for which you can be discharged. In the outer earth, any service and probation is subject to discharge too, so the work is not satisfactory. But it is such a probation in which you cannot be discharged, you see. But truly you become a follower when you meet the Master within and talk to him face to face. He is ever with you and you are ever with him. So this day, when you say birthday, physical birthday, I think the best way of just celebrating the birthday is live up to what the Master said. That's all. And I don't want anything from you except love. Love and all things shall be accepted to you. That's all right. Have respect from heart. You see, it is no matter of joke. The more you live righteous life, true living, live up to what you are told to do, that eases the burden, my burden. You help me, that's all I can say. Understand.
निरंजन